Hey guys, it's Roxy again. Today I'm going to show you kind of like an everyday look, but kind of for the fall. It's a little bit darker. Normally for the summers I use golds and browns and everything to do my everyday look, but for the fall I use kind of purples and blues and maroons and everything. So today I'm going to show you a look just by using Trish McEvoy makeup. Here's my little palette that I've developed, and today I'm going to be using this white color, this kind of like skin tone color, and then this maroon and a little bit of this purple, and it just makes this look, if you guys can see. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with that. So first, what you want to do is you want to prime your eye. I'm going to be using Trish McEvoy Eye Base Essential. Let me turn this down a little bit. Okay. I like this one. I don't like it much as Urban Decay Primer Potion, but I like this because it has a pigment in it, and it actually gives me kind of a little bit of a base to start off with. If you guys can see that, it's got a nice little color to it for me. So I'm just going to spread that out, and this gives me a nice canvas to start on. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and take a eyeshadow brush, and I'm going to go ahead and take this skin base color right here, and I'm going to put that all over my eye, from the lid up to the eyebrow bone. This just kind of evens out the skin tone of my eye. Okay, and now what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and take this white eyeshadow, and I'll put that all over my lid. Okay. So now that I have my white eyeshadow on, I'm going to go ahead, clean off your brush. I'm going to go ahead and take some of this maroon color right here. It's a really pretty color. Any kind of dark maroonish purple color you have would work. So you just want to take a little bit, you're just going to kind of build on top of it, tap off the excess, and you're going to start from the outside corner, and you're going to work your way into the crease. It's really rainy here in Baltimore right now, so it's kind of a gloomy day, unfortunately. Make sure you blend that out really well. Alright, now just build on it a little bit. Now I'm just going to blend it out a bit. Give you that little bit of an airbrush look. That's how you want all your eye makeup to look. No real harsh lines. Just little circle motions will do the trick. Okay. Now you're going to really build on this color by adding that really pretty purple I showed you right here. But just a little bit at the beginning. You don't want to add too much. Just take a little bit, tap off your excess. And then you're just going to start again, and you're just going to swoop just a couple times in the crease. A little bit more. Start in the corner and just swoop into the crease. Okay, and now you want to blend the two colors together. Just strange. Whenever I'm doing my makeup, I always find I do my right eye better than my left eye. It's just, I don't know why I do it better, but that's always what happens. So I'm constantly always trying to even out my other eye. I don't know if any of you guys have the same problem, but that's probably my biggest problem. Okay, I'm going to just take a little bit more of the maroon color. Just on top. Okay. So I'm hoping you guys can see that. Okay, and now you're going to go ahead and put your highlight color. I'm going to take a little bit of this, the base that I put all over, the skin color one. Just going to pat it on my brush. I'm going to start from the middle of my eyebrow where the arch is, and I'm just going to work it down. You don't really need a really strong highlight for this one. Just because you don't really need the focus to be here. You just want it on the maroon purple part. So just work it down into your other makeup. Right here, and just move it down. Okay, and now we are ready for all the liners and mascara and all that good stuff. So, where is my liquid liner? Here it is. I'm going to go ahead and start with my lower waterline. Just going to line that. Don't put too much just because this is a daytime look. I like to put a little extra just on the outside corner. Make your eye look a little bit bigger and bolder. Now what you want to do is go ahead and line your top lashes with a liquid liner. I use kind of like a little pen device, but I'm going to go ahead and try out the whole, I'm going to get the hip cream liner, and I'm going to try that out and I'll tell you guys what I think, but for now this one definitely will work. Start off very thin. You don't want just this big bold line out of nowhere. I like to start from the beginning, go to the middle, and then stop, and then go to the end, and connect it. To me, that's just the easiest way for me. Thicken it just a little bit. Okay. There that is. And now all you need is to curl your lashes. Put a little mascara. On your lower lashes. And that's it. Alright, enjoy your Trish McEvoy look. You can substitute any of the colors that you saw today. I really like this look just because it brings out your eyes without being too dramatic and using too dark of colors. So I hope you guys try this look. I hope you guys like it. Keep watching my videos, subscribe, and I'll see you guys all soon.